All right, guys, welcome, man. Your eyes are not deceiving you. We are back. Now, y'all voted on the poll in Miami of Ohio. One that, you know, situation. And, you know, Ohio's been difficulty, you know, see the game rules, you know what I mean? Just letting y'all know up front what we rocking with, you know what I mean? And these are the settings. J-Kit Sliders, that link will be in the description. As I'm just breezing through, just feel free to pause it if you want to. This is what we rocking with. This is my settings. Now here's computer settings. You know what I mean? So it's going to be a long journey. And I will cover each prospect in this video, man. Some of the original prospects and some of the newcomers. So first up, your boy Jalen Eaton. Even though it's a lot of depth in front of him, I'm just going to go ahead and treat it like a real life situation to where he's, you know, even though they play 3-4, Eaton will, you know, back up, you know, Dylan Moses. You know what I mean? So next up is the quarterback, Chase, from Auburn. Going to Auburn, you know, actually. And, he, of course, you've seen in the highlights, man. You know, I think he's going to be special, man. I think he's going to have to battle it out with Bo Nix. Next up, Isaiah, man. This kid is fucking huge. Bro, this dude is fucking huge, man. I believe I said his storm power at like 92, 93, somewhere up there. So it's only going to get better. Next, Dante Smith, one of the original prospects, man, coming out of Clemson. Now, they got a lot of weapons. I will kind of bump them up being in the starter. Now, some of these players, you know what I mean, hopefully they won't transfer. And Kirkland Jr., this dude is a beast, man. You're just straight beast middle linebacker going to Clemson. And, you know, a lot of depth is in front of y'all, man. But, you know, I'm trying to get y'all to where y'all playing time, to where y'all don't transfer, you know what I mean? Next up, Barry Smallwood III, a big-ass linebacker, man. A big-ass linebacker. One of the few prospects that went to my real-life team, the Florida Gators, you know what I mean? Next up, Deshaun Brown, Florida State. Now, you know what I mean? Even though he's fourth on the depth chart, I kind of will bump him up either at the starter or the second string. You know what I mean? Trying to get him some playing time, man. The next loaded team is Caden Perry going to Georgia. This team is loaded as well as Ohio State, man. The Ohio State is fucking loaded with talent. You know what I mean? Even though he got Zaire White and James Cook in front of him, you know what I mean? He going to have to battle it out. Now, Preston Reeves, the monster, man. 6'5", 205. Now, even though it says he's from Florida, I don't know if he's from Florida. You know what I mean? I don't know where everybody's from, so I just left it alone. If y'all catch on to that. Next, Malcolm Chamberlain, 6'3", 270. This dude is fucking huge, man. Like I said, a lot of depth in front of him, man. He's just going to have to battle it out. And, you know, trying to get y'all some playing time so y'all don't transfer. You know what I mean? Next up, Jaden Jones. They got some, him and Parker, man. Yo, they got some talented cornerbacks from years to come. Years to come, man. Both of them got speed. Justin Parker want to kick return and punt return. Add some dimension to that offense. Overall, the team, man. It's the Danon Lemon Jr. Y'all seen the highlights, bro. I think I'm going to have to bump up his drilling and acceleration. You know what I mean? But, yeah, 6'6", 245. Yo, he's going to be a beast, man. Y'all seen the highlights. All right, man, Mr. McNeil. Yo, I had to. When I made these highlights, I had to match up that purple helmet and purple jersey, bro. Them things was, yo, them things was lit. But as you can see, ratings on him. David Weaver is another original prospect. Now, if they can get a decent quarterback to give them the ball, yo, their offense is going to be something else to work with. You know what I mean? And next up, Daquan Moore. You know what I mean? If you see this video, I didn't know what number to put you, so I just put you at number 8. You feel me? Now, this position isn't anybody's to take, man. He could be the backup, he could be the starter. Now, I think I'll go ahead and bump him at his starter. I mean, Christian Bates, 5'10", buck 70, wide receiver. Even though I might got his dimensions wrong. But coming to North Carolina, man, you know, Mac Brown is changing that program. And Keneal Johnson, the 6'2", 195 corner. Now, believe me, Cloud is a senior, so it's definitely a good situation for Mr. Johnson. He's going to come in and basically take it. He's already a starter, but he's going to be QB1. Now, CB1, my bad. Now, Ohio State, JoJo Harris. I'm telling you, this team is loaded from top to bottom, bro. Top to bottom. Georgia Air is coming in as a loaded Ohio State team. Next up, DJ Brown, the fucking monster, bro. This dude, y'all seen the highlight? Y'all seen dude arms? Like, what? Bro, this team is loaded, man. Frederick Walls III, the 6'3 monster corner. Like, you will not be able to throw on this defense, point blank. I mean, it's that serious, bro. Dorian Clarington. Yo, this team is fucking loaded, bro. I wouldn't be surprised if they win a national championship. Now, this coach, Chris Treadwell, I decided to leave him at, you know, linebacker. He will start. And he wanted to do a free safety. But, you know what I mean? I just left it like it is and left outside linebacker. You know what I mean? Even though he got people in front of him, go ahead and slap him in starting rotation. Now, PPE is another one. I'm telling y'all, this team is loaded. I mean, loaded. I don't see nobody. You can't run. You can't pass on this team. It's going to be something to work with. You know what I mean? And DJ Watson is, he's in, I wouldn't say a tough situation, but a good situation to where he can take the starting role. You know what I mean? He just got to work for it. That's all that situation is. A quarterback, man, Landon Rankin. I believe one of the first people to enter, you know, his name. So his original OG prospect, and of course, Justin Fields leaving, and that's going to leave the door wide open. You know what I mean? And Speedy Mayor, his name speaks for itself, man. The name speaks for itself, bro. Speedy Mayor, him and Hasselwood, bro. Yo, with Rattler at quarterback? Yo, get the fuck out of here, bro. Next, man, Jose Salinas, running back. I believe he definitely fits well in his offense, man. That kind of speed back Oregon system, yo, that's a 1-2 combination. And I would try to throw him in there in the mix as well. Now, my team, bro, it's not looking good, bro. We got a long hill to climb. Even though a lot of these 80 ratings, some of them, most of them are upperclassmen. You know, we will have to slap on some redshirt freshmen, but you know what I mean? It is what it is. And Avion Smith, bro, he cannot throw, but being how the revamp has, you know, special packages in the playbooks, we're going to have to slap him at running back, wildcat, receiver, anything on offense to get this kid the ball, man, because you can't ignore that speed. And Besters is our top receiver running back, my apologies. And it's not a lot of speed, so that's something that we definitely have to address in recruiting. Oh boy, receiver, bro, is not looking good. Hello, Hempenhammer? Yo, you can't get no favor. Mac Hempenhammer, bro. He has to speak. Yo, y'all, we gonna have to get him some kind of playing time. I'm sorry, y'all. Hempenhammer, bro. All right. Let me go back to this kind of thing, man. But Homer is our best tight end. But, you know, Jake has a speed. Redshirt freshman. So, I'm definitely liking that. We got to throw him in the mix. Even at starter. Even though the ratings is not where it's supposed to be. You can't ignore that speed once again. Left tackle. We definitely need to address that. And it looks like the left side of this offensive line is definitely the strong suit of this, you know, front line. And the right side, we definitely have to work on, man. Most of them are upperclassmen. Some of them, you know, underclassmen. So there's something that also we're going to need to address in the recruiting. Left end, we definitely need to address speed. Just going through this, we definitely need to address the speed. So a lot of these guys fit a 3-4 scheme. And it look like we will have to go that route until we get some more speed. You know what I mean? And once we do that, we will go to a 3-4. We got a lot of depth. That's a good thing on a interior defensive line. A lot of underclassmen, so that's definitely something that we don't have to worry about. And, you know, not a lot of speed overall on this team, man. So we definitely need to get kids in here to, you know, change that atmosphere. You know what I mean? Because you can't teach speed, man. You definitely cannot teach speed. And then just looking through this, even though the ratings of these linebackers are decent, once again, need to address speed, man. Speed. And looking there, I thought I can change their position, but you got to wait to the offseason to that. So definitely gonna need to make some adjustments on that. Cornerback wise, yo, Emmanuel, I can't even pronounce your last name. I'm not gonna try, but he's our best cover corner, even though the speed is not there. You know, Boswell definitely will make up for that, so that's definitely a good thing. And this dude has some damn good coverage skills. The speed is just not there. I would say arguably the best cover corner in the nation. Even though the Raiders don't back it up, yo, you can't knock that, man. Boswell definitely has a speed. Wish he was an underclassman. Now, outside of that, it's pretty much a drop-off. So, like I said, we definitely have to recruit smart and recruit well. You know what I mean? So I believe this is a two-star program, so we only going to recruit two-star and below. You know what I mean? And over whatever pipeline states that we are connected to, we are, you know, allowed to recruit. And whatever states that are touching or, you know, near Ohio, those are the states that we will recruit. You know what I mean? So, like, if it's a two-star, three-star prospect that we into, but he's not in our pipeline, is it not connected to Ohio, we won't be allowed to recruit. Now, go ahead and do this, so I want y'all to think I'm trying to, you know, create any kind of prospects. I mean, I'm going ahead and saving it now, so I don't want y'all to think that I'm cheating, but we wind it down towards the end of the video, man. Appreciate y'all. Love y'all to death. Y'all already know who it is. And I'm gone. Got it out of mud, yeah.